So, in my last class, I have already discussed about half-life period. And half-life period of a radioactive element is the time period during which the substance just decay to half of its original value. That means, suppose the complete element is 100%, 50% of the element will decay in this time period. So, this time period is known as half-life. And we have to know one important thing about that half-life, that when the time is T half, that means will take half time of the decay, and that the substance will become half of its original value within that time. That means in T half time, the substance become half of its original value. So when T is T half, that means for one half life, N, the number of the atom left undecayed, becomes N0/2. So in another half life, that means after two half lives, N will become half of N0/2, that means N0/4, or we can write it like this, N0 1/2 whole square. And after it another half life, that is after three half lives, N will become half. You just see here half of N0, here half of N0/2, and then half of N0/4. It will increasing like that. After three half lives, N will become half of N0/4. So it will become N0/8, or we can write it like this, N0 × 1/2 whole cube, and so on. Hence, after N half lives, the number of the atoms left undecayed, N equal to N0 1/2 to the power N, that is equal to N0 ½ to the power t/T. That means the total time period within which the disintegration will occur is the product of the number of the half lives into T half. It will be T half. So N/N0 equal to half of N, half to the power N, or half of, since this small t equal to N into T. This one is T, capital T here denoted the half life. We can write it T half also, capital T denoted as T half, half life of the radioactive element, the time period within which the substance becomes half of its original value. And this N/N0 will become half to the power N, or equal to half small t by T. From here, N will become small t by capital T. Then come to another factor, that is average life. The average lifetime of a radioactive element is obtained by calculating the total lifetime of all the atoms of the element and dividing it by the total number of atoms present initially in the sample of the element. That means, in shortly, if you understand this thing, we can say the average lifetime of the radioactive element is the total time period within which the substance reduced to completely, the time period within which the substance will disintegrate completely means 100%, that is the average life of the substance, and it is represented by the symbol tau. This symbol you will learn in 11th class, so it is represented by tau. And average life of a radioactive element is represented mathematically tau equal to 1/lambda. The physical statement tells us that it is the total time period within which the substance reduced completely. And mathematically, the tau, that means the average life, is defined as reciprocal of the decay constant. And from equation 5, I have shown you that equation 5 in the previous class, I have discussed that T half equal to 0.693 by lambda. Here we have to put the value of lambda. So from this equation 5, lambda will become 0.693 divided by T half. So it will become finally lambda is 0.693 by T half and tau equal to 1 by 0.693 by T half. Tau equal to 1 by lambda, we have to put the value of lambda here, that is 0.693 by T half, or equal to T half divided by 0.693, and 1 by 0.693 will become 1.44 T half. So the average life of the radioactive substance is 1.44 T half. This is nothing but the relation between half life and average life period of a radioactive element. This thing you have to remember, and you have to solve many problems from using this formula, that average life and half life. So tau equal to 1.44 T half. The average life of radioactive element is, from the relation we can easily say that the average life of a radioactive element is 1.44 times of the half life. Then come to one problem we have to solve using the formula for half life and decay constant, average life also. So the question is like that: a radioactive isotope X has a half life of 3 seconds. So the radioactive isotope will exist for 3 seconds. At T equal to 0, a given sample of this isotope contains 8000 atoms. So the given sample contains 8000 atoms for a given time. And you have to calculate its decay constant, average life, the time T1 when 1000 atoms of the isotope remain in the sample. And next, the number of the decays per second in the sample at T equal to T1 second. So simply here in the first case, you have to calculate the decay constant, that means lambda. You know the formula for lambda, that is 0.693 by T half. So T equal to T half equal to 3 second, and 0 means initially present atom is 8000. So lambda will become 0.693 by T half, or that is equal to 0.693 by 3. It will become 0.231 second inverse. Then we have to calculate the average life. So tau equal to 1 by lambda we already know. So 1 by lambda means 0.231, it will become 4.33 second. And the next one, the time T1 while 1000 atoms of the isotope remain in the sample, that means 1000 atom will remain. So how many will lost? So one thing, this much amount of the atom will left. So n, in the initial we are taking the conditions that n is the number of the atoms is present initially, number of the atoms which remains after decay, and n0 is the original number of the atom, and we have to calculate this time period. So n by n0 equal to half to the power n, this relation you know, from that special note, the relation, that is n by n0 equal to half to the power n, and n is 1000 divided by 8000 equal to 1 by 2 to the power n. So 1 by 8, this 0 0 is cancelled, so 1 by 8 equal to 1 by 2 to the power n. So this will left side will 1 by 2 to the power 3. So 2 into 2 into 2, that should be 8. So here n will become 3. And since we know the relation that total time is the product of that n, number of the half-lives into t half. So number of the half-life here, n is 3 and half-life 3, so it will become 9 seconds. Next, you have to calculate in the question that number of the decays per second in the sample at t equal to t1 second, number of the decays, how many decays will occur. So you know dn by dt at t equal to t1 equal to lambda n, so lambda will we have to put into n, means total number of the atoms left on decay after the disintegration, total number of the atoms left on decay after the integration. Then come to units of radioactivity. As you know, to measure all the things we need the help of the unit. Like that, to measure the radioactivity, or simply we can say to measure the activity of a substance, we need the help of some units. And the activity, maybe this page will not clearly visible to you, therefore I am just repeating the sentence and you have to note down from that. The activity of a radioactive source is measured by the rate of disintegration of the source. I am repeating again, the activity of a radioactive source is measured by the rate of disintegration of the source. And first unit is Curie. It is named after the famous Nobel laureate Madame Curie. That the activity of a radioactive sample is said to be 1 Curie when 3.7 into 10 to the power 10 decay takes place in every 1 second. I am repeating again to make the note. The activity of a radioactive sample is said to be 1 Curie when 3.7 into 10 to the power 10 decay take place in every 1 second. That means if in every 1 second 3.7 into 10 to the power 10 decays will occur, then we can say that is 1 Curie. And we can express this Curie in terms of decays per second. So 1 Curie equal to 3.7 into 10 to the power 10 decays per second. 1 millicurie, like that we can say, milli means 10 to the power minus 3, so it will become 3.7 into 10 to the power 7 decays per second. 1 microcurie, you know, micro 10 to the power minus 6, so it will become 3.7 into 10 to the power 4 decay per second. So we can express Curie in terms of decay per second. Another famous unit for radioactivity is becquerel, and in short form it is written as BQ. Like that, Curie is written in short form CI. And becquerel also one of the famous scientists who gave the famous law regarding the radioactivity. So the unit is named after him, that becquerel. And this becquerel is the SI unit of the activity, means radioactivity. And 1 becquerel, we have to express becquerel in terms of decay per second. So 1 becquerel is equal to 1 decay per second. Decay per second is the means normal unit. We have to express all the units in terms of that. So 1 becquerel equal to 1 decay per second. And 1 curie, curie and becquerel can be interconverted. 1 curie equal to 3.7 into 10 to the power 10 becquerel. Next, another unit of radioactivity is Rutherford. And this, you know, the famous scientist Rutherford, and this unit is named after him. The activity of radioactive sample is said to be 1 Rutherford when 10 to the power 6 decay takes place in every 1 second. It is just definition like the becquerel. If 3.7 into 10 to the power something decay occurs, then it is said to be 1 Curie. Like that, if 10 to the power 6 decays per second occurs, that means 10 to the power 6 decays occurs per second, or simply you can say 10 to the power 6 decay per second, then that is 1 Rutherford. So 1 Rd, in short form it is written as capital R small d, 1 Rd equal to 10 to the power 6 decay per second. Next, some problems are there and you have to solve. I think this problem is repeated again and you have to solve yourself. I have solved it before, here also maybe I have solved, but you have to solve it. A certain element has half-life period of 30 days, find its average life. So half-life is given 30 days and you have to calculate the average life. So half-life t half is given 30 days, and as you know the relation between half-life and average life is average life is the reciprocal of half-life is the reciprocal of average life. So t average life is the reciprocal of this decay constant. Average life is reciprocal of decay constant, that is equal to 1.44 t half. So 1.44, this half life period is given and that is 30 days, and so multiplying this you will get the half life period of the radioactive substance is 43.2 days. And this, the question is repeated again. I have solved it just before. You have to solve it your own, because own means I have already solved. So you'll see from that, or you can check yourself as you can solve or not. A radioactive isotope has X has half life of 3 seconds at t equal to 0, that means at the initial stage. A given sample of this isotope contain 8000 atoms. You have to calculate the decay constant, average life, the time t1 when 1000 atoms of the isotope remain in the sample, and number of the decays per second in the sample. So you have to solve your own, because I have already solved it before also. Then another question you have to solve your own, but I have given some hint which makes the tasks easier. You can easily solve the problem by following that hints. So the question is like that: a radioactive element reduces to 25% of its initial value in 1000 years. What is the half-life of the element? So many data are given. The radioactive element reduces to 25%. You have to calculate how much will reduces and how much will remain, and reduces to 25% 1000 years time is given. You have to calculate the half life. So one thing is given, 25% remains left, but this relation, you know, n by n naught equal to half to the power n. So 25 by 100 equal to half to the power n, and small n equal to 2 and small t equal to n into t half. So what is the half life? You have to calculate the half life. So you can calculate this n is already calculated, and t, so from this relation you can get this tea hub. You'll solve your own and ask me through WhatsApp if any doubt is there. Another question which are the tax for you, but here I have make your tax easy by giving some MCQs, some answer which are probable answer, so you can solve and you may confirm that is the answer is in between here or not. And if any doubt, you can also contact me. So half life of a radioactive element is 40 minutes. That means already T half is given. What amount will remain on decay after 4 hours? So when the radioactive reduces to half of its original value in 40 minutes, you have to calculate what amount will remain on decay after 4 hours. And the next question, which is the task for you, you have to solve that a radioactive substance. The question is like that: a radioactive substance decays to 1/16 of its initial activity in 40 days. The half-life of the radioactive substance in days you have to calculate. Two problems are same in structure, so you will try. So this is